Hi class, good morning. So our topic for today is Forensic Ballistics Part 2 Lecture. So this is your instructor, Mark Anthony Aljan. So let's begin. So our lesson objectives is after this lesson, the students will be able to discuss and explain the four divisions of ballistics and the ignition system. So the four branches of ballistics is or are the following: internal ballistics, also known as interior ballistics; transition, also known as intermediate ballistics; external, or also known as exterior ballistics; terminal ballistics. So let's begin explaining and discussing internal ballistics. So kita nyo sa illustration ang there is a motion or a process of the firearm inside while before the bullet is being exploded outside the firearm. So as you can see here, di ba, na siya ay proseso. So ang proseso ani gistadihan. So it is now known to be internal ballistics. So we define it as the study of the motion of the projectile. So ang motion sa projectile dito while it's still inside the firearm, which extends from the breech to the muzzle. So from breech to the muzzle, okay. It also refers to the study of what happens within the barrel of a weapon. So gastudy po siya kung unsay nahitabo sa barrel of a weapon from the moment the firing pin hits the primer to the time the bullet exit from the barrel. So from the moment the primer firing pin, this one, hit the primer. So interior ballistics, as we all know, it is the study of motion of projectile within the gun barrel. So the time during which the projectile is influenced by the interior ballistics is very short. So ang time frame mana very short lang, seconds lang na class. So from the release of the firing pin to the moment the sound of the shot can be heard, as it leaves the muzzle, occupies only about pila ka seconds, 0.01 seconds in modern rifle. So modern rifle ni, so ang karaan na rifle siguro 0.02 or 0.03 seconds. So interior ballistic involves the following: so ignition of the primer, flames is produced, combustion of the gunpowder, energy that is generated, force, pressure developed, velocity of the bullet from the chamber to the muzzle, rotation of the bullet, engraving of the cylindrical surface of the bullet. So naay mga engraving. So as we discussed it last week sa atong firearm identification. So ignition system. What is ignition system? So when the firing pin strikes the hammer, the primer compound explodes. So ito ang ignition. With the great velocity causing jet of flame. So dagan kayo na kalayo. Often extremely high temperature to pass through the flash hole into the propellant chamber. This jet of flame with a temperature of about 2000 degrees Celsius ignites. So grabe kainit. The propellant, which burns at high speed to form a large volume of high pressure gas, which accelerates the bullet down to the passageway of the barrel. So there are two types of ignition system. It is the Baxter system and the Burden system. So as you can see class, these are the difference between the Baxter and the Burden. So sa Burden, ang primer niya inani. So primer mixture, nasa yung primer mixture, nasa yung primer foil, ayan, anvil, Baxter type, ito, parang ganito. And primer, ito yun, nandito yun, nakakover, primer cap, flush hole, nandito, di ba? So sa Burden type naman, meron siyang primer cap, pareha sila, di ba? Staked and securing of primer, napa siya'y security. stake na tinatawag itong stake securing of primer. Na yung mag stick anvil of burden type. So, muna siya. Madre. So, unsa ning duha ka points. Plus shoal yapon. Dahil po dahil yung password. Dari. Bali duha sa bird boxer. Isa ra. Dari. Bali duha ka hole. So, primer foil. Ayan. Andyan din. Primer mixture. Pero yeah. So, yun yung ratimanan. Ang difference is ang flash hole, dalawa dito sa burden type. Tapos, meron siyang stick securing of primer. Okay? O, different ang iyang shape sa iyang anvil. Di ba? Okay, class. So, related terms. Mga related termino na dapat natumbalan sa interior ballistics. So, number one is action. So, it is term referring to the mechanism of firearm. Number two is burning rate, an arbitrary index of the quickness that burning propellant changes into gas. Burning rate is controlled by a chemical composition. So, ang burning rate daw kinakontrol sa chemical composition. The size and shape of the propellant grains and the pressure at which the burning takes place is IMR 5010. Powder is very slow burning and bull's eye is fast burning. So, muna timanan class. So, bulk density. Sa maning bulk density? It is the ratio of the weight of a given volume of a powder. So, unta siya? Ratio of the weight of a given volume of a powder versus the weight of the same volume of water. Chamber pressure. The pressure generated within the chamber. So, commonly, chamber is generated from a pressure generated in the chamber. So, tinatawag chamber pressure. Erroneously called breech pressure. So, pwede rin siya, ay tinatawag din siyang, I mean, breech pressure. So, kaya naman sa chamber. So, charge weight to bullet weight ratio. So, meaning charge weight. So, it is a ratio of weight of the powder charge to the weight of the projectile. So, muna siyang charge weight to the bullet weight ratio. So, detonation. So, unsa man detonation in the interior ballistics? It is the chemical rearrangement of molecules into gas instead of solid to cause the high explosive to exert full power of shock. The speed of detonation varies in different explosives, but in some, it is as high as 7,000 yards in a second. So, try to remember it, class, ha? 7,000 yards in a second. So, energy. So, unsa man ning energy? It's measured in foot pounds, and 1 foot pound means the amount of energy which would be capable of lifting a weight of 1 pound through a distance of 1 foot drop block action. The type of action in which the breech block raises and forces vertically, it cuts in the receiver sidewall's lever actuated as a rule. So, muna siya ang tinatawag na energy. Expansion ratio. The expansion ratio is the ratio of the capacity of the powder chamber plus bore in grains of water to the capacity of the powder of the chamber in grains of water. So, muna siya tinatawag na expansion ratio. So, unsa man ang foot? Foot is a pound. The amount of work required to raise 1 pound 1 foot high against the force of gravity. So, foot second. Velocity expressed in foot per second. So, foot second. Yam kakusgun expressed in foot per second. So, gas is a fluid resulting from the combustion of gunpowder with a relatively great expansion and spontaneous density. Mo-expand siya, so, mo-span. Hang fire. It is refers to the occurrence when a cartridge fails to explode on the time or delayed in firing. Hang fire ang tinatawag. So, unsa man na, pag delay gani, no? Yan na, cartridge fails to explode og dalawa, delayed in firing. Madelay siya pag buto. Tinatawag siyang hang fire. So, the power of the bullet which delivers a very heavy paralyzing blow but that put the victim down and may then recover it if the wound inflicted upon is not fatal. So unsa man siya tinatawag ng power? Knocking power. So if the wound is fatal, dili jud ka recover ang naigo. Loading density. So it is the ratio of the weight of the powder charge to the capacity of the powder chamber. Case. It is usually expressed as the ratio of the charge weight to the capacity of the powder chamber in grains of water. So generally, the more fully powder charge fills the case and case, the more it is too slow. Too much free space in the case, it can cause erratic ignition. So, too much free space in the case, it can cause erratic ignition. Change in the pressure curve, moving the peak towards the muscle or even over a rapid burning. So, tinatawag detonation din. Of the powder charge, one reason manuals list minimum or starting loads. So, sa misfire. Misfire is the total failure of a cartridge to discharge. So, try to remember ha. Misfire. Wala jud ni gawas ang cartridge sa iyang firearm to discharge. This is different from hang fire, which merely a delay of combustion. So, mubuto ang pusil, gawas ang bala sa pusil, pero delay lang. Na-click na nimo ang trigger. Mga napay seconds, aya pa ni buto. While misfire is a complete failure even though to start combustion. So, pag-click mo sa kuhan, wala dyan siya nag wala siya nag-produce of combustion. Powder chamber capacity. As with most interior ballistics capacity measurements, it is usually expressed in grains of water. It is determined by measuring the weight of the water that a fired gauge from the test firearm can contain with a bullet seated to its normal depth. Note that this varies with the different bullets or seating depths as well as the dimension of the chamber and the brand of the case. So, powder chamber capacity na siya. So, what is pressure? Outward push of gases from powder combustion against cartridge. So, muna siyang outward push sa gases against the cartridge case, chamber, and the bore. Sectional density. So, muna yung sectional density. It is the ratio of bullets weight in pounds. So, muna na weight in pounds to its diameter. So, PSI, pounds per square inch. Pounds per square inch. It is often seen designated as PSIA. This designation is now used to signify a measurement of chamber. So, asa siya gamiton para sa measure ang chamber pressure taken with a piezoelectric device. So, piezoelectric units operate in a similar fashion to the copper crusher units but use a reusable crystal crusher that charges its electrical properties in response to pressure. When connected to suitable recording equipment, the entire pressure pulse history can be recorded or displayed. The peak pressure recorded by the piezoelectric peak device usually reads about 5,000 psi, higher than the figure determined by the copper crusher method. So, what is recoil? So, as we all know, it is the equal and opposite reaction of the gun against the forward movement. So, ang gun, padulong siya forward, pero gani siya recoil backwards of the bullet during the explosion. Residual pressure, it is the pressure remaining in the chamber. So, asa nimo siya makita? Sa chamber after the bullet has left the barrel. So, it is the pressure remaining. So, muna, mga powder na black powder residue na mabilin sa chamber. Transition ballistics. Unsa na po ning transition ballistics as one of the division of ballistics. So, it is the study of projectiles. So, another, it is the study of the projectile's behavior when it leaves the barrel and the pressure behind the projectile is equalized. So, also known as intermediate ballistics. It is the study of a projectile's behavior from the time it leaves so the muzzle until the pressure behind the projectile is equalized also. So it lies between the asa man siya naglies sa internal ug external ballistics. So between siya dere tinatawag siyang transition ballistics. So interior ballistics. What is interior ballistics class? So when you say interior ballistics, tika mo lang. You can see ito pala yung tika lang. Before we discuss what is interior, okay. What is transitional period? We discuss also first what is transitional period. So transitional period is the complex field that involves a number of variables that are not fully understood. Therefore, it is not an exact science. So when the bullet reaches the muzzle of the barrel, the escaping gases are still in many cases at hundreds of atmospheres of pressure. Once the bullet exits the barrel, breaking the seal, the gases are free to move past the bullet and expand in all directions. So, parang gina-conceal pa siya kung napa siya dari sa muzzle, ang gases. So, pag magawas na ang gases sa iyang muzzle, unsa may mahitabo sa hundreds of atmospheric pressure. So, mukhaan siya, mu-expand in all direction. This expansion is what gives gunfire its explosive sound. So, ang tinatawag na expansion na yan, mu-give siya og explosive sounds. So, muna siya maduog na buto. In conjunction with the sonic boom of the projectile, and it is often accompanied by a bright flash as the gases combine with the oxygen in the air and the finish combusting. So, mag-create siya og bright flash light. So, these are example of the transition ballistic. So, as you can see, ito yung, unsa man eh, ito yung internal ballistics. Dito, interior or external ballistics. Ito. So, ito yung ginasinasabi na gun expansion, di ba? Pag magawas ng gases, mag-expand siya. Okay? So, balik ta sa exterior. Exterior ballistic deals with the motion of projectile from the time they leave the muzzle of the firearm. So, the time they hit the target, the flight of the muzzle bullet or the projectile does not exceed 30 seconds at maximum range, which for almost, is firearms is obtained at an elevation about 33 point. So, mga condition na nag-refers to the natural laws sa exterior ballistics. This is the velocity, energy, the yaw, gyroscopic action. So, when you say velocity, speed per unit of time. So, yung M16, example niya, ang yang speed niya, 3,300 foot per second. So, ang energy, fatal equivalent of a bullet. So, ang energy, yan yung fatal equivalent of a bullet. Yan kakusgan. Ang yaw is the unstable rotating motion of the bullet. Ang bullet, gani-rotate yan, pero pag unstable yan, tinatawag na yaw. Nagyawing ang bullet. Parang hindi siya pa-strict. Ay, hindi talaga yan pa-strict. Yung bullet na hindi siya mata-hit sa target. Gyroscopic action refers to the stillness of its rotating motion and attain its highest momentum or stability in flight and penetrating power. So, muna siya ang tinatawag na gyroscopic action, stillness of its rotation and motion. So, fix yung gayo ang rotation. So, in interior ballistic also class, there are elements such as shape, caliber, weight, initial velocities, rotation, air resistance, gravity, help determine the path of the projectile. So, these are the elements na mag-create og factor sa path of a projectile from the time it leaves the gun until it reaches the target. So, further, so External ballistics or exterior ballistics refers to the attributes and movements of bullet after it has left the gun muzzle. So, ang movement sa bullet after it has left the muzzle. So, tinatawag itong exterior ballistics also class. So, unsa man mga attributes o mga movements ang gina-include ani, naatay muzzle blast. So, when you say muzzle blast, the noise created at the muzzle point of the gun due to the sudden escape of expanding gas coming in contact with the air in surrounding atmosphere at the muzzle point. Diba? Ang cause ani doon sa transition period na ni siya ang muzzle blast also na bilong. So, muzzle energy, energy generated at the muzzle point. So, unsa man ang energy na generate sa muzzle point, tinatawag siyang muzzle energy. So, trajectory. Trajectory is the actual curve path of the bullet during its flight from the gun muzzle to the target. The following are the kinds of trajectory: straight, horizontal line, or parabola-like flight. Vertical drop, or tinatawag ding vertical drop. Range, the straight distance between the muzzle point and the target. Accurate, effective range, it is the distance within the shooter has control of its shots, meaning he can place his shots at the desired spot. Muna siya tinatawag na effective range or accurate. So, maximum range is the farthest distance that a projectile can propel from a firearm. So, unsa muna yung farthest distance? Natawag siyang maximum range. So, unsa ganun ang accurate range? Kung ang shooter has control of his shots, ibig sabihin na siya ay kaya niyang asa dapat madesire ang shot o asa niya paigun ang kontra. So, tinatawag yun siyang effective range. While the range at which the ordinary pistol and revolver are supposed to be effective in only 50 to 70 yards, all of them can send their bullets much further than that and are capable of inflicting fatal wounds at distance up to 1 mile depending on the caliber and gunpowder content. So, tinatawag siyang long barrel life rifle is up to 3,000 yards. Accurate range and its hinge muzzle velocity of 1,000 to 4,000 feet per second. So, bullets from rifled weapons spin at 2,000 to 3,000 revolution per second. But over the first few yards of trajectory, distance varies with the weapon. So, their flight is slightly unstable. So, unsa man ang nagahitabo? So, nag-unstable ang flight niya. So, the end of the projectile wobbles before it picks up a smooth flight path. This phenomenon is called tail wag. And it's as is of considerable importance in evaluating gunshot wounds. A bullet with tail wag does not strike its target clearly. So, bag mag-tail wag ani, dili siya mo strike its target. Dili ni mo ma-desire na makuha ang effective range. Diba? So, exterior or external ballistics also refers to the attributes. So, muna siya Japon, ha? Mga attributes or movements. Air resistance, pull of gravity, and penetration. So, muna siya air resistance. Resistance encountered by the bullet while in flight. So, pull of gravity. So, in common sense na ito na class, pull of gravity is a downward reaction of the bullet while in flight. So, penetration. So, when you say penetration, the deep of entry. So, asa man siya deep of entry? From the target. Okay? So, let's go about discuss on terminal ballistics. So, when you say terminal ballistics, it is the study dealing with the effect of the impact. So, unsa man siya? So, ang iyang study, nag-deal siya sa effect of impact of a bullet on the target. Unsay action sa bullet kung mahit na siya sa target. So, penetration of the bullet is of prime interest. So, penetration is important also in determining safety requirements for target backstops. It is also the study of interaction of a projectile with its target. So, may interaction sa target. So, thermal ballistics involves, unsa man ang gina-involve sa thermal ballistics? Terminal accuracy, terminal energy, terminal penetration, terminal velocity. So, unsa man siya? Terminal accuracy is the size of bullet grouping on the target. So, when you say terminal energy, energy of the projectile when it strikes the target, also known as striking energy. Unsa man siya ang terminal energy? Projectile when it strikes the target, also known as striking energy. So, unsa man ang terminal penetration? So, unsa man ang terminal penetration? It is the depth of entry kasi may penetration of the bullet from the target. So, terminal velocity, speed of the bullet upon striking the target. So, mga common na mga denominator na itong class is the penetration, velocity. As we all know, energy, it is the penetration, also known as striking energy, accuracy, so size of the bullet, grouping on the target. So, penetration, depth of entry. Bilang nyo say velocity, speed of the bullet. Na naman yung mga terminal. So, na yung terminal, nakabutan ng terminal penetration. So, depth of entry of the bullet from the target. When you say terminal velocity, speed of the bullet upon striking the target. So, muna siya mga denomination na dapat natin tandaan class. Okay? Terminal ballistic also deals with the destructive action. So, nag-deal po siya o destructive action and effects. Occurs at the end of the projectile's flight as an integral and undeformed body. So, the flight may end in one of two ways. So, unsa man, the projectile may strike a solid obstruction. So, number two, its metal case may be broken or by the explosion of a bursting charge. So, tungod sa explosion of a bursting charge, the metal case will be broken. Muna siya ang mga destructive action na effect pod sa the projectile from hitting the target. So, asa man siya naginahit? Sa solid or the metal case may be broken due to explosion or bursting charge. So, that will be our end of our topic class. Thank you and God bless.